Amen. Thank you, Jerry. All right.
Oh, how happy I will be when life's journey here is run, and I look upon his face and I hear him say, well done. You have fought a faithful fight, and my child, you've kept the faith. In and out, my joys are yours, so just step inside the game. Inside the game.
inside the gate. I had God. He said, I just want to just barely get, honey, I want the world to know when I get, I'm going to run through that gate. I don't want to just tiptoe. Let's just worship the Lord tonight. Amen.
transgressions, and he was bruised for our iniquities. Surely he bore my sorrow, and by the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can feel the rush of angels' wings. I see glory on His face.
Time and hours. called his mighty name, church. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. Shatana Mo. Sing it out tonight. Let the heavens ring tonight. Voices and hands toward heaven tonight. Let's magnify the Lord with unified effort tonight. Let's magnify the Lord. He's worthy, church. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be magnified tonight. His name is great. His name is worthy tonight. Father, we honor you tonight. Lord, I come to worship. Lord, I come to bless you. I come to magnify you. Lord, I come to glorify. I come to lift up the mighty name of Jesus tonight. Father, I thank you, Lord, that you're the Alpha. Lord, you're the Omega tonight. Lord, you're the first and you're the last tonight. Father, I rejoice in your work tonight. I rejoice in your love, Lord. Lord, you are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Hallelujah. You're worthy, Lord. You're worthy, Lord. Church, whenever you worship the Lord tonight, you are paralyzing the enemy. Hallelujah. I said you are paralyzing the enemy when you worship the Lord tonight, when you glorify, when you magnify God. The devil can't do nothing. He becomes paralyzed. Let's sing it one more time. Put all your effort into it tonight, would you please? Just put everything you got tonight, Lord. Lord, I'm going to worship you with all of my being. Lord, with all of my heart tonight, God, all of my strength, all of my energy, Lord, I'm going to worship you, Lord. Go over it. I feel the Holy Ghost tonight. Woo. Oh, there's healing in the house. There's deliverance in the house tonight, church. Woo. They're all over this place tonight. One more time tonight. Sing it out, children. Lift your voices tonight. Bring it to the Lord tonight. Hallelujah.
We are standing.
Hallelujah.
On holy ground.
My Lord. My God tonight.
Oh, and I know that there are
Give the Lord a good hand clap of praise tonight all over this house. Let heaven hear you tonight. Amen. Let the heaven hear. Woo! Hallelujah. What a mighty God. What a mighty God. I said he's a chain breaker tonight. He's a burden bearer tonight. He's a yoke destroying God tonight. He's a mighty God who's able to heal, renew, restore, regenerate. He's the one that binds up. He binds up our wounds tonight. Woo, shit about one more time, guys. One more time. I feel the Holy Ghost, church. Sometimes we just got to press through the crowd. Sometimes we got to push through the atmosphere. Say, Lord, I ain't leaving till I get my healing. Lord, I ain't leaving till I get my breakthrough. Woo, my Lord. I just dare you tonight to press in tonight. Just press in tonight. Press in and let God begin to heal you tonight. Woo, my Lord. Tonight, Lord. My Lord, my Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for the work that you're doing tonight.
We are standing in his presence.
Oh, sing it one more time. Then lift your voice. And one more time. Just one more time tonight.
For we are standing,
yes we are,
on holy ground.
Hallelujah.
And I know that there are angels all around.
Oh, they're all around us tonight. They're ministering tonight. So
let us praise my Jesus now.
Hallelujah. You're worthy, Lord. You're worthy tonight.
We are standing in his presence. We are standing in his presence.
Your voices and your hand toward heaven tonight. Let's give God the praise and the glory. Father, we come to bless you. Lord, we just come to worship and magnify your holy name. Lord, you are the true and living God. You're still the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob tonight. Lord, we still look to the one who created the heavens tonight. Lord, you're still Elohim tonight. Lord, you're still the mighty God, Lord, who saves. And we just going to honor you and bless you tonight, Lord. Lord, you still ride up on the circle of the earth tonight, Lord. You're still the wheel in the middle of the wheel. Lord, you're still the rose of Sharon. You're still the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. Father, I'm just going to celebrate. I'm going to rejoice in you, Lord, for your unspeakable gift tonight. Lord, we bless you and we give you praise and glory for it. In Jesus' mighty, mighty, mighty name. And the whole church said amen tonight. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor! We're going to make it. Praise God. Praise. Shake hand with somebody. You may be seated. Thank you. Praise team. Lord bless you. Lord love you tonight. Man, I feel the Holy Ghost in this house. Woo, if you don't get it, it's your own fault tonight. I told Brian Hilbert the other day, I said, if you don't get your blessing, I'm going to get it.
Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Brother Kevin. There's a victory here tonight, folks. There's victory in the house tonight. Praise the Lord. Job said, though God slay me, yet will I trust him. But he also said, in my flesh, I'm going to see him. Matthew the 8th chapter, and he was come down from the mountain. Woo! How many know what he did on the mountaintop? He was up there praying.
Yeah.
He was up there interceding. He was up there getting refreshed. Why? Because there was somebody in the valley that he needed a touch. I said, somebody in the valley needed a touch. So he was up there praying, preparing himself, preparing his heart. And he said, when he was come down from the mountain, there was a great multitudes that followed him. And beheld, there came a leper and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. How many know God is able to us? I said, God is able. God is able tonight. Verse 3, and Jesus put forth his hand and touched him. How many want to touch the hand of Jesus tonight? Or the hand of Jesus just touch you tonight? Let the hand of God just touch you tonight. He said, the Lord said, write this down, underline it tonight. I will. I will. How many know it's God's will for you to be healed? It's God's will for you to be whole? It's God's will for you to be ever with whole tonight? The leper said, Lord, if you can make it clean, then I will.
Yeah.
He didn't have to think about it. He'd already prayed up. He'd already had it in the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God was in Christ. He said, okay, if that's what you want, I'll do it for you.
Yes, amen.
Just ask in our church. If you act with him, let him ask God. But if you need a healing tonight, just ask him. Ask anything in his name and he will do it. He said, I will. And he said these words, be thou clean, and immediately. How many like to walk out and immediately touch by the hand of God? You know what? God can do it if you'll just believe it.
That's right.
If you'll just believe it tonight, praise God. Praise God. He said, I will be thou clean. And immediately his leprosy was cleansed. Can I get a shout? And Jesus said unto him, see thou tell no man, but go thy way, show thyself to the priest, get him examined. He said, and offer the gift that Moses commanded under the law for a testimony unto them. And when Jesus was entered into Capernaum, there came unto him a centurion, beseeching him, saying, Lord, my servant lieth at home, and he is sick of the palsy. He is paralyzed. He is grievously tormented. I'm shaking hands with a gentleman in the house this morning. You know, I try to give a pretty good grip. I want a good handshake.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
And he said, don't touch me. He said, my hand hurts. Maybe the much more want to grab it and just hold on to it and just shake the fire out of it and say, heal in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
But I refrained.
No.
I restrained. He said, you just speak the word only. Church, that what you hold in your lap tonight, what you hold in your hands, that is the word of God. And in that word you hold up, there is power. I believe it's Ecclesiastes. He says, where the word of the king is, there is power. Where the word of the king is, there is power. The centurion understood tonight, Jesus, you're the King of kings and Lord of lords. If you will just speak the word, my servant shall be healed. We need to learn to speak what the word of God says to do tonight. Amen. Learn to speak this word over our heart. I learned this a long time ago. I told this testimony several times. But back in my younger days, when I was fit as a fiddle, strong as an ox, and serving as a mule, and all that good stuff, I used to play basketball up at the gymnasium with all the young bucks. Thought I was just as young as they were. And I would go home after the 2 or 3 hours of playing basketball, and my feet would hurt so bad. I had heel spurs. And I would go home, and I would cry like a baby. I would just cry in pain and agony. And this went on for time and time and time again. And I went through the same pain. I loved basketball so much, I would just go and endure the pain. And I'd get home, and I'd pay for it. And my wife and kids would just get around my feet, and they would pray for me, and I'd just sit there in pain. It was painful. And I had come in one Monday night, and I was just hurting worse than I ever had before. I got aggravated so much, and just to the point of just horrendous. And I went into my bedroom that night, and I just cried out to God. I said, God, you've got to heal my feet tonight. And these words, I will never, never forget. God said, I want you to stand on my word. Opened my Bible up, and I took it right here to Isaiah, the 53rd chapter. And I laid out before my bedroom. I took my shoes and socks off. In church, this old big old fat boy climbed in the word of God, barefoot on both feet. And I began to praise God. Before long, I felt the healing power, a healing virtue of God being released into my body. And I'm here to tell you, I've never had another heel spur. I've never had another foot pain in my life. I said, the word of God is power. If there's an ache in my pain, ache in my body, instead of getting a heating pad, For unto the gospel, he said, as well as unto them, but the word preached did not profit them. We can preach the word, but he said it did not profit them because it was not mixed with faith in him that heard it. You can preach the word in your own faith, but if you don't have faith to mix with it, it's kind of like baking a cake and not putting no eggs in it. Ain't going to turn out. Ain't going to turn out. But if you take the word, the spoken word, the written word, the rhema word tonight, mix it with faith, the centurion understood that. He said, you speak the word, you speak the word. And he said, if you go to the word again, he said, I'm not so found so great of faith in Israel, and I say to you that many shall come from the east and from the west and shall sit down with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven, but the children of the kingdom shall be cast out of darkness, and there shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth, verse 13. And Jesus said unto the centurion, go thy way, and as thou hast believed, so be it done unto thee. Somebody shout tonight. As you have believed, well, Lord, I don't think I got my healing that way. Probably didn't.
Probably not.
No. Well, old Jim Bob, he got his healing tonight. I sure wish I could have got mine. Well, the gospel being preached, you just need to activate your faith. Now, to God can work out of mercy. God is merciful in healing it as well tonight, amen.
Yeah.
But faith is what moves. I've not seen so great a faith going on here. God is looking for our faith to be mixed with the spoken word tonight. But he said, as you have believed. There's one guy in the Bible, he said, Lord, help thou mine unbelief. When he said, Lord, help thou mine that I may believe tonight, he said, and he believed, and so be it done unto thee. He said, and the servant was what? Healed. And the servant was healed. He wasn't even there. He was home. But because somebody stood in the gap. Somebody stood in the gap with their faith and they believed God for them. He got his healing at home. I remember hearing not long ago, but a few years ago now, I had a pain. Mother, you can remember this. My leg hurt so bad. I had to get my dear old sweet mother to put my shoes on. I had to call her up at 11:30 that night and say, Mother, can you come down and help me get my shoes on? That's kind of embarrassing, folks. That's kind of embarrassing. That you can't get your own shoes on. I could not bend my leg. I could not bend it one eye left. And that Sunday morning, it hurt so bad that I called us. I came here, and the church began to pray for me. And I was at Cottonwood Creek. Is that right? Cottonwood Creek. I was passed over the bridge, and I felt the power of God hit me that morning. And I looked at the clock, and I said, the church is meeting and praying right now.
Yes.
God healed. Well, I'm here, I'm not in God tonight. When I was a youngin', I'm giving my testimony to the healing power of God. When I was a youngin', I mean just a youngin', I had a big old wart about the size of my thumb right here beside my cheekbone. Folks, that's embarrassing being a kid. People make fun of you on the school bus and all that stuff. That's horrible. But I went to church that Sunday morning and my grandpa was there and he said, son, come here, we're going to pray for you. You don't see no warfare today, folks. They laid hands, the church gathered around me, they laid hands on me. And within 2 days, there were things falling out of that thing.
Thank you, Lord.
It began to dry up, seed, looked like seed just began to fall out. Church, I've never had that. Come on, somebody. I say, when God makes the utter end, affliction shall not rise up only a second time. God's word is true. It's a spoken word. He said, if you'll speak the word only, my servant shall be. If God spoke the word, and he was healed that very same hour. That's the God I serve tonight. Amen. That's the God I serve. And Jesus came. When Jesus was going to Peter's house, he saw his mother's wife laid, and she was sick of a fever, and he touched her hand, and the fever left. Well, let's get the Tylenol out. Well, let's get out the menthol. Get out the menthol. you thought that was a miracle drug. Other than the thought turned upside down, you hauled with a miracle drug. I'm glad I didn't believe the word of God so on an easier. It's just a whole lot easier. Just believing the word. I say, Lord, I believe every word. This time I grab you to get it. So it's in there. And I believe it for it. And she arose and ministered. That's what we're talking about. He restores. She got up and cooked him supper. She didn't lay around and cook for 3 or 4 days. She got up and cooked supper for him. Now, that one guy said, he said, Lord, he said, the preacher walked in. He said, don't pray for me. He said, why? Because he said, I might get my check off. Hold on. God has been so good to me. My uncle, he was a Free Will Baptist preacher, circuit preacher. There were horses, that's how old it was then. Circuit line.
Oh, yeah.
And I heard my grandpa tell this story. He said there was no rain, there was a drought going on. And he said they called for a prayer meeting out in the local church. And he says, my uncle went down to the church at night, he got down there and went over to his horse and started taking the saddle off. They said, what are you doing? He said, we come to pray for rain, didn't we? And the story goes, when they walked out of the church at night, the rain was coming down. Folks, if we'll prepare.